The tractate Psachim is a tractate dealing with three main subjects. One is chametz and matzah, what is the unleavened bread and matzah. Second one is the sacrificial offering of Pesach. And the third one is the eve of the Passover Seder. The tractate of Passover is dealing with a lot of mitzvot. The Rambam said that it's 24 mitzvot out of the 613 mitzvot apply specifically for Passover. 3 positive, 15 negative, and 4 chametz and matzah in the story of Egypt, and 4 positive and 12 negative in regard to the offering of Passover. The reason we use plural, psachim, and not Pesach, anybody know? Why we call it psachim and not Pesach? 2 reasons.
Well, they're
first,
referring to the Passover sacrifices.
Excellent. So yep. It means that there are many, it's right. Not one. Mm-hmm. The second, there is another chance, it's Pesach Sheni.
Right.
The first one, the second Pesach, there are second chance, which we'll discuss later. Now, the tractate divided to different sections. There are 10 chapters. The first one we're going to deal today in the upcoming several days is the first one in the search of chametz, search of unleavened bread. The Torah tells us that we have to get rid of the chametz, but there are different categories of getting rid of chametz. One, it's in our heart, and the other one is physically to get rid of the chametz. Biblically speaking, it's enough that the person annul, abrogated, expunge from his heart the chametz. Rabbinic speaking, we have physically to search and burn the chametz. What is the chametz as far as category? Chametz, it's anything that carries the 5 species of grain that not exceeded 18 minutes, which means anything that have a 5 species of unleavened bread, which is in Ivrit, chita, seora, shibolet shual, kisemet, and shipon, which means help me out.
Wheat, barley, oats, spelt, and
rye.
Thank you.
So any one of these 5, very nice, that exceeded 18 minutes where is moisture with water and puff up, it's considering a
chametz,
which is 11 bread. Now, with that in mind, we go to our Mishnah. It's a tractate Psachim. Or le-14 bodkin et ha-chametz le-or ha-ner. The Mishnah tells us that the eve of the 14, the month of Nisan, we search the entire property using candles. Here we have a different opinion between Rashi, which is the early 10th century in French, Germany, great commentator, who said that it's a violation of which we call Bali Ra'e u Bali Matzeh. The Torah tells us it should not have in our midst any type of leavened bread. So a person, in order for him not to violate that law, he needs to have a physical searching of chametz in his domain and by using a candle to search. That's Rashi's way of understanding it. Tosfot tells us that it is a rabbinic that put a decree in order to avoid a person from violating Torah law, meaning that by searching for chametz, you avoiding yourself from using the chametz and eating it. Meaning, yes, biblically speaking, it's enough for a person to declare that he is ownerless of the chametz. However, the reality is that if a person see chametz, he may even unwittingly going to eat it. So you may ask, but I already I declare ownerless. So it's not mine anymore. But since it's in your domain, and it may happen that you're going somehow to use it for all kind of maybe unintentional or press circumstance or all kind of a situation, because during the course of year a person is not avoiding himself from being attracted to the chametz, because that's the foundation of food day by day that people using. So the Torah used the term karet, which means that soul shall be cut off, etc. It's a very strong a statement. So Tosfot tells us that's the reason, in order for a person not to reach a point of eating it for all kind of reasons, we go ahead and said, yes, it is very good to declare ownerless, but that has to be a second after, first and foremost, searching the chametz in a physical manner to make sure that you don't have it, and physically expunge it. And then you declare the ownerless. Now, the first statement said that use the word or. Or, later the Gemara explained, that's the Eve. Even the term or, Rashi tells us that it's when you see a light, it's in a day. But either you go by the Rashbam that tells us in the Torah that it was an Eve and it was a day, that in the Jewish calendar you start in the Eve before, and since in the Eve time it's dark, so you need to use candle. But also, the idea of or, that brings several sources later, that it's applied to the time of light. So I'm giving you a little vignette today of Kabbalah. The rabbi says us that when we study Torah, it's not only studying the text or understanding the text, it also applies to our inner neshama, to our inner soul, that exposed to a different domain. So the rabbi tells us that since Passover, it's a time of getting out of Egypt, of exile, and some rabbis say that Egypt also applied to a personal limitation, a personal sorrow, a personal challenges. So therefore, there is a light that the person needs to search, make the search, by using candle. Candle, it's applied to the inner soul. And therefore, the light that the person needs to search apply in a concept of duality, individually and collectively, because every action that I made affected me individually and affected the society at large. So they said, when is the time that the person search? Is a time of great darkness, which is the night. That's the time that the person search using candles that apply to make self-search and apply to take a very serious thinking about himself and his life and his world. And well, the time of great darkness, that's the time that a person needs to go. Now, the Mishnah said, if a person have any type of chametz, he is in violation of what? The Torah said, bal yira'eh u'bal yimatzeh. You should not have it in your midst. So, Rashi tells us here that the source is, the Torah said, velo yira'eh lecha. You should not have in your midst, which means you cannot have it in a sense of seeing it in your property. Now, yes, we just mentioned that later the Gemara said in page 4 that there is a way to do it by making that declaration that I'm ownerless of the chametz. Now, the fear is, later the Gemara explains, that a person may not make that declaration in full sincerity, which means that he said something. Unfortunately, you see it a lot by people, they said something and they don't fully mean it. So that's a very big discussion about selling the chametz, etc. The key point is, a person can declare ownerless, but the next thing, if he's hungry, etc., etc., he may go and said, "Oh, I didn't mean it sincerely," which means lo yevatel yafe. It's not a full sincerity. So, Rabbeinu Nissim Deran tells us that that's the problem. Either a person unintentionally going to eat it, like Tosfot said to us, or the Pnei Yoshua said that if he's not making this declaration in full sincerity, so therefore he can enter domain of violation of Torah law, and that's the source of the issue. Tosfot tells us later on page 10b that is another issue here. If we have a chametz, if we have the leavened bread that passed through the time of Passover, which means a fellow Jew that carries a chametz and Passover is over and he did not get rid of that chametz, so it's considering chametz that avar alav Pesach, that Passover went through without getting rid of that chametz. And that's a problem. You cannot any longer use it because that chametz passed the violation of Passover. So therefore, that's the reason Tosfot said later in page 10 that the person need to search. There are two opinions. There is one opinion in Tosfot there that said even after Passover, a person need to get rid of that chametz because of a violation of Passover, and therefore he need to search even after Passover. Rashi disagree, and we basically follow Rashi in that sense, that only searching for chametz has to be up to the time of Passover, because that's applied to what we said earlier, bal yira'e or bal yematzeh. You should not see it and you should not have it in your meat. Okay. So now we said that at the eve of Passover, a person search for chametz, and searching for chametz has to use the light of candle. Where is it? Kol makom she'ein machnisim bo chametz, ein tzarich bdika, which means any location that we don't put a chametz. Give me an example. What location we don't put chametz? An example.
We don't normally put chametz.
An example, something that people usually don't bring chametz to.
The bathroom is one.
Bathroom. Some said, it's a question, but let's say if you go to the roof, soon you see a question about basement. Right? Those places are questionable if a person have chametz or not. So general statement, they said, any place that we don't enter chametz, you don't need to search for that. So Rosh Yosef said, because you're not in violation of neither rabbinic nor biblical. So now we go to the next tape. We talk about basement. Ubame amru shtei shuot b'martef. What did the sages meant when they said you need to search the basement, the cellar? So think together. In those days, but some people even in our times, they have in their basement what?
Wine cellar.
Wine cellar, excellent. So you have a wine cellar, and those barrel of wine was setting up in a certain way. They have those barrels that setting from the bottom up to the roof, to the about a little less than the ceiling, and then they go widely throughout the basement. either in nowadays big companies or individuals that have their barrel of wines. Now, what's the issue? So the Gemara later explains that imagine a well-to-do person that have a servant in his house. And sometime during the meal he said, oh, I have all these guests, I would like to drink a good wine, bring me some wine. He asked the assistant or someone in the house, and that fellow goes to the basement while carry a pita bread, or I carry a sandwich or something because he's doing the meal, and maybe a crumbles or part of the bread spread there. So you don't ask the person to go and search the entire basement in between those barrels, because again, so far, people don't go to spread the chametz. Those barrels are all year around staying there. Where is the area that the person access to pull out some wine? So there are two views. The rabbi said in general, it has to be two lines, shte shurot, two level, two rows of wines barrel in a cellar. So they said, one said, Beit Shammai Omrim, Shtei Shurot Al Pnei Kol HaMartef. They said that the two row for the entire cellar, and Beit Hillel Omrim, Shtei Shurot HaChitzonot Shehem HaElyonot. Later the Gemara explained, but in general I just want you to imagine. So one said that you go one on the top of the other up to the roof, you go to two rows that way. And the other one said, which is Beit Hillel, no, you go only by the place that there's a chance to enter the chametz, which is the external part. You go widely on the those rows, not from the bottom to the top. Gemara, my all. Gemara asks, what does that mean when you use the term or? Why? Because when you use the term or, meaning what? Or is light. Mm-hmm. So what we understand or? You send the opposite, you send the dark, is the eve. My or, Ravuna amar nagei, v'Rav Yehuda amar leilei. Ravuna said, meaning what? Really
Ravuna
light.
Said it's light, yeah.
Light, meaning soon you see, using yeah. light, right? And Rav Yehuda said, no, that's applied to night. Now we need to explain it. Kasal kadatach demanda amar naghei mamash. You may think that when we use the term light, it means actual light of the day. And that's not what we meant, right? Actual light of day, meaning the day of the 14th of Nisan. Uman de amar leilei. Leilei mamash, when once said night, means the actual evening of the 14th. So, the question is, when using the candles in those days, all right? And nowadays we try hard to use candles, as long as it's not hazard issue. So, using candles, when you need to use candles? When it's dark. Mm-hmm. So, meitive. Now we need to go and explain how that match, because when you use the Ivrit, the Hebrew term, or, is the opposite than Laila. Mm-hmm. It's not really opposite, because the real opposite of Laila is Yom, is day.
Right.
But it's still. So now we go and bring a source from the story in the book of Bereshit, Genesis, story of Yosef, biblical Joseph, and his brother. You remember the story of Egypt, that Yosef sent his brothers, asked them to return to their home and bring the other members of the family. Mm-hmm. So the Torah said in the Bereshit 44, Haboker or ve'anashim shulchu. It was as soon as it was morning, the people, the men, which is his brothers, were sent away, there and their donkeys. So what did they say? Or alma or yemamau, which means when the sun rises, and yom or its day. The Gemara rejected and said, Michtiv haboker haboker or. They didn't say the verse, the light is a morning. They said morning is a light. It's like someone who said that tzafra, meaning the morning, is light. So it's like you're using the light as a verb versus noun.
Right.
Right? So kidrav yudah marav. Rashi, by the way, used the word klomar. I don't have enough time, but in my book, Biyorei HaKlomar Berashi Al HaShas, I explain why they use the term klomar in the Rashi. So they said here, Damar Rav Yudah Amar Rav, Lo'olam yikanes adam bechi tov, ve'yetzeh bechi tov. He gave an advice. He said, a person should enter when it's light outside. So in other words, he should enter the hotel or the place of lodging when it's light outside. It's a good advice. And then when he leave, it should be when it's light outside, not dark. Because Rashi said that may in those days have wild animals, have robbers, it's all kind of things. Tosfot said that it's because there are cisterns like pits. There are in those days you have demons fear, etc. You don't see them when it's dark. Marsha and Chatam Sofer have other interpretation. So they said the fact that you see the brothers of Joseph waited until it's light outside. This is the meaning of that using that term. Meitive ucheor boker yizrach shamish. He said in the book of Samuel, chapter 23, that when is a day, you see the sun. So this is euphemism that speaks about the end of the days, and also they speak about the difference between our world, mundane world, and the afterlife, the world to come. So they speak here about the righteous man, that when he move from this world to the world to come, it will be like a person go in those tunnels from great darkness to the light. You see a lot of nowadays people who go through, God forbid, but happens, clinical death, and you hear the same story from all of them, that they see a big tunnel, and at the end of the tunnel they see a tremendous light. So it's like an expression that the same way as you see a light in the boker in the morning, the same way you see the sun. Alma o yemamau. So you see here the term or applied to the day. So that's basically, again, we ask the question on the Mishnah, why is they use the term or? So the Gemara rejected, said miktiv or boker uche or boker ktiv, which means we are very scrupulous with every word. So, every letter, so they use the letter Vav and letter Kaf, Uche O. Ve'ache ke'amar, and that's the way we explain it. Uche O boker, when the sun beginning its rising, which means sunrise, that it's still before dawn, it's dark. Ba'olam hazeh, in this world, ke'ein zrichat shemesh le'tzadikim la'atid lavo. The same way as the righteous person at the end of the day, they see a great light, which means in the world to come, the light of the sun will be in such a brilliant, magnificent, that even when it rises, it will be a tremendous amount of effect on our souls. And in order to make it less obstructive and more applicable, they use the euphemism or the simile of this world, which is the sun and in the darkness of the night. Now, they said here, so they said, "Keor boker ba'olam azeken zechat shemel atzil ad lavo." Okay, Meitivei. So they ask another source from Bereishit, chapter 1. Vayikra Elokim la'or yom, al ma'or yemamau. You see that Hashem, at the very beginning of creation, He called the light day, which means the light is an application toward today. So light is a day. So it's different. So Pnei Yoshua explained here that's a different source because of the connotation of the text. But back here they said, Hacheke amar, Lameir uva krao yom, which means the one that it's coming out of darkness and come out to us, that's we call day, which means the moment you see the very beginning of the dawn. You're sitting outside. Imagine we have a beautiful city here, the capital of Maryland. The only city is no train station, right?
The only capital city in the United States without a train station. That's right. Correct.
So you have a lot of tourists from New Zealand and from Australia and from all over the world that come for the boat show and boat races and things. So you see these people sitting on the boat or the sitting on the city shore and waiting to see the sunrise, because it's beautiful to watch in our city the sunrise. So if you look carefully, it's a point of total darkness. Mm-hmm. Suddenly you see a sprinkle of very little light that in a matter of seconds, later minutes, it changed to a day. So they said, La Meir Uva Krao Yom. When it starts getting the light and coming stronger and stronger, that we call O. Ela Me'ata. So now, when Hashem putting a name, quote unquote, to those entities at the beginning of Bereshit, what does that mean? Velachoshech Kara Laila. So he called the darkness night. La Machshich Uva Kara Laila. The same manner. You're sitting when the sun set, it's very relaxing mood, right? And you meditate and you're watching the sunset. Many people feel that it's very healthy. So even it's not fully dark yet, but it's getting closer and closer and closer, that's already we call a night.
It's interesting, in English when you refer to the morning light, it's referring to a direction.
Direction.
It's the east.
Beautiful. Mm-hmm.
So when you say, if you walk by the morning light, it means you walked in the eastern direction. So
Beautiful. Mm-hmm. But you know that in halacha it's a lot of application, because ben hashmashot term, which is when it's a twilight, have a lot of halachic application.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
I give you just one of the extreme examples. If a baby born at that time, mm-hmm. and you need to measure the time of the breed, especially if it's 8 days later, if you go ahead and using all the needed for Shabbat, because Shabbat supersedes the others for the breed, or not, you need to wait for the following days. So it's in the matter of sometimes a very small, short time of minutes, mm-hmm. or even seconds to determine. Now we said, V'ha kaimelan de'ad tzeda kochavim yemamau. But we learned that until the sprinkle of the stars, the very beginning, that's considering the, if you remember when we studied Tractate Brachot at the very beginning, mm-hmm. we said that until the Tzet HaKochavim, until the fully sunset and you see the very beginning of seeing the stars,
right.
still considering a day, speaking here about Safek Yom Safek Laila, that you are not sure if it's day or night. And nowadays it's especially in the long summer, we ask question about davening mincha, making the afternoon prayer and knowing the exact time. So they said here, El Ahachika Amar. That's the way you understand it. Kar Yerach Manal Lin Hora Ufak De Mitzvah Ladi Amar VeKarach Man LaChashocha Ufak De Mitzvah Laila. Beautiful. There are many names of Hashem. One of them is God full of compassion. We call it in Aramaic, Hebrew, Rachmana, or Rachum, Rachman, Kel Rachum, in Arabic also use the same term, right? Rahman al-Rahum. So they said here, God full of compassion, called the day light, which means he created that entity, that light, and serve him. So he asked that entity to serve him during the day, and that's a commandment that he called, and therefore that entity reflects to a certain period of time, and it's called a day. The other one is the entity of darkness, like the nine plagues in Egypt. So that God called in the book of Genesis, like king call upon his servant, he give him the definition of his servant, Rashi said. And therefore, that's the goal, that is the name that made by God applied to a certain job, certain object needs to do. So now we solve the issue of the day, but we need to understand what Rav Huna said, that the light, meaning day, in the using this term. So they said Meitivei. They said in Tehillim, in Psalm 148, Halleluhu kol kochvei or. That's a psalm that we said every morning. So we all know that when you see a stars, you see the stars only night, not during the day. Alma or urtau. So you see here the letter, the word or, alev vav reish, is basically in Aramaic the word uta, which applied to the night, because they said in Tehillim clearly it's applied hacheka amar. No, they said hallelujah kol kochavim amirim. That's applied to the commandment upon those stars that bringing lights in a time of darkness, which is night. Ela me'ata kochavim amirim udebau shabuche shena meirim lo bau shabuche. So there are different stars. You're going to tell me that the stars that commanded to praise the Lord apply only to the star that sprinkle light, and those stars that you don't see light, they don't command to serve God? No. V'aktiv alelu kol tzva'av. They said the same line in the Tehillim in Psalm 148, that all God's arm apply also to the stars that you don't sprinkle light. Ela hakamash melan. The old kochavim nameo. So they said here, the Maharsha and Tosfot Arosh said, the old kochavim nameo, which means that the light of the stars, it's also considering light, even you don't see them in the same equivalency as the light of the sun. Lemaina nafkamina. What's the difference? He said, lenodera na'a mina'o. We talk about a person that commit himself to something. So they have a via negativa or positive. What is via negativa? So let's say if a person commit himself for avoiding himself or driving any joy from the light. Person can commit himself to anything and everything, basically by making statements. In general, later we see definitions, but in general, if some person said, I commit myself not to derive any joy from light. So generally speaking, he applied to what? Even the light of the stars. Because at the dark night, the star lightning give us some light. Detanya, anoder mina or asu beoran shel kochavim. If someone avoid himself from deriving joy from light, it's applied even to prohibited benefit even from the light of the stars. Meitive. Now we go by Rav Yudah that said that or apply to the night. They said in the book of Job, Iyov, chapter 24, La'or yakum rotzeach, iktol ani ve'evyonu b'layla yichr ganav. He said that, again, he speaks about more metaphor. He says a murderer rises with the or to kill the poor and needy, and the night he is the thief. So the language of the Tanakh is always hakbalot, makbilot, equivalency. And he said that the murderer come and do this thing on the or. So what we understand that that's applied to the night. And you see here the term or that used for the night. We just turned the page. So when we use the term and it's light, he will be like a thief, it means apparently that the light applied to the day. So in that sense, what does that mean? When people are traveler on a road, this murderer is standing in those intersections and kill those travelers in order to take their money. And at night, he is like a thief that go while it's dark and enter to those private domain and steal money or items from people. So here we juxtapose the two, which is we use the first source for a person who commit himself to prevent himself from using the light, right? Next, we brought the source from the book of Job that applied to the murderer and thief. And you see here a term or for the night. So they said, Hatam, the Gemara rejected, said, Hachi kama, Yipshit alach milta kinora nefashot kai, Rotzeachu venitan lacilo benafsho. Vimesapka lach milta belelia, Yeh benecha kegana velontan lacilo benafsho. If it's clear to you that these thieves come at night and his intent is murdering people, meaning if the owner will stand against him and not let him rob him, he will kill him. So he is under the category of a murderer, and you can go ahead and save him. There is a concept that's called Rodef. What does that mean, Rodef? Rodef is, if you see a potential of someone that it's clear to you that he's about to kill, let's say you see, God forbid, someone who pull out a gun and about to kill, or you see a shaheed, a person who's about to blow up himself, God forbid. So even it didn't happen yet, it can happen in a matter of minutes or 5 minutes or hour, but if you see it coming there, we allow to go ahead and be the first one to get rid of him in order to avoid him killing us. Okay? Haba lehorgecha ashkem lehorgo. So here, if you are in doubt, like night, what happened to the night? You don't see it clearly. Those of us, like Gil, myself, and others that serve in the army, they know that when you do navigation at night, in my time, I assume in your time too, that they used to do navigation alone.
Yeah.
So you do navigation alone, you use a compass, and you by yourself, you see a lot of things that are very far, looks like very close. Right? It's a common mistake. So that's applied to the night. So it will be like someone who comes to steal money. And therefore, we allow to kill a thief only when you know clearly that he will kill the persons who try to avoid him. Otherwise, you're not allowed to kill him. As long as it's not clear to you that his intent is to kill, if you are not going to give him the money, you're not supposed to kill him. Only if it's clear to you. So they said here, Meitivei. Again, what Rav Yudah said. They said in the book of Job, chapter 3, Hine alayla hu yehi galmud yecheshchu kochve nishpo yekav laor v'ayin v'alirei baf ha'pei shachar. Here, again, he's speaking the language of euphemism. And he speaks about that night that he yearned to see light, and it will be like a sparkling of the dawn. Mideke amar yekav laor v'ayin, from the statement that said that he yearned for the light and is no light. Remember the book of Job speaking about, God forbid, the crisis that befall upon a person and he doesn't see the light at the end of the tunnel. So he said here, Alma Or Yamamahu. From that connotation, we learn that use the term Or, meaning light, it's applied to
day.
So it means that when you are in a great darkness, when a person is in a great darkness, you yearn to see the end of the situation, the end of the crisis, the end of the day. Imagine, God forbid, but it happens in our history, people in the concentration camp, people in a ghetto, people in all kind of situation, and they have no clue how that will end. And we know that Hashem is always there, but they said in the book of Iyov, in the Job, that all of a sudden so many crises, one befall upon him, one follow the other, beginning with losing his wealth and losing his families, and then himself afflicted with all these terrible diseases. So he started cursing Iyov the day that he was born, the night that his mother conceived, etc. That was a time of crisis. Yov used the term, the Ramban tells us, he like cursed those stars that appeared to that night that his mother conceived. So he said, Hatam meilatu dekalait Yov lemazale. At that time, Yov just curses mazal. How do you say it best, mazal? I don't know how to translate it.
It's luck.
Luck.
Yeah. I mean, yeah.
Lucidly.
It's bad luck. Yeah. I mean...
Bad luck or bad...
bad fortune,
Bad fortune, bad connotation.
Yeah, bad fortune, I think, is probably...
Amar yeherava delitzapeach gavra linora velo lishkechei. So this is Aramaic. He said, may it will be that person, meaning Yov himself, yearn to see a light. However, he never see the light at the end of the tunnel, which means that again we don't see a full clear source, that Or meaning day. Meitive. Now we try to bring another source from the book of Psalms 139. Again, talk about the person in a huge crisis, which our beloved King David. And King David said that he thought that with all the sorrow that it befall on him, that he will die at the midst of his great sorrow. But at the end, he says, "Velayla or ba'adeni." King David is an expression, Rashi said, of the hope, right? So many people follow this teaching of Book of Psalms. So he applied Alma or Yamamahu, that he talk at the midst of crisis, that he see the lights. That's the great King David. So they said here, now it's the opposite. You see the night applied to the great light. Hatam, the Gemara said, Harek Amar David. That's what King David said. Ani amarti or ach or choshech yeshufeni la'olam haba shudome leyom. I thought that in the afterlife, in the world to come, I see darkness. Achshav ha'olam hazeh shudome le'layla or ba'adeni. He was afraid that God is not forgiving for his mistakes, for his sin. So we all know the story with Bathsheba, etc. And King David thought, that's Gemara tells us in Sanhedrin, page 107, that he thought that it's God is still angry at him and he didn't forgive, even he confessed and even he regret and even he expressed his great remorse, a great contrition. But he wasn't sure that Hashem forgave him for that. So that it means that when he saw the light at the end of the tunnels, he understand that God forgive him. So what we understand, that Or, it's not necessarily application to the day. Or can be like a personal expression of forgiveness. Meitive. We learn now from the Mishnah that we're going to study Mitzvah Shem, page 10. Rabbi Yehuda Amar Bodkim Ol Arba'asar Shachridu B'Shat Abihu. Rabbi Yehuda said there are basically three times to search the Chametz. Or in the eve of the 14th, during the morning Shacharit, and during the time of burning the Chametz. So later we explain if that means the three times of searching, or only one of the three, that you have a choice between the three options. So they said, "Midekama Rabbi Yehuda Butkin or Ba'asar Uber Ba'asar Shacharit Alma or Outahu." So because he said that you have this idea of the eve, the morning, it means that Shema Minah, that's the conclusion. So that or apply to what? Tonight. So literally speaking, as much as sounds like or meaning light or day, here the connotation is night, which is, we always say that we start in the eve before the 14th. Meitive. They still challenge what Ravuna said. We are talking about doing some type of work at the eve of Passover. So the Mishnah tells us at the beginning of chapter 4 that there are different minhagim, the different traditions among communities. And the Mishnah there discuss what happens if someone travels from one location to another, which minhag he needs to observe. So they said there are locations that said that a person should not make any work even before Chatzot, which literally meaning the midst of the day. That's it's a well-known minhag. The Mishnah tells us in page 50 that it's a well-established minhag. Even the code said in the 468, the code said that it's apply only from Chatzot, from the middle of the day and onward. So they said here, Rabbi Eliezer ben Yaakov omer mishata or, which means from the time of the light. Rabbi Yehuda omer mishata netzachama. Rabbi Yehuda said from the dawn. Amar le Rabbi Eliezer ben Yaakov le Rabbi Yehuda, v'chan matzinu yom shemikzato asu ba'atziat megachom kisato mutar ba'atziat. Where do we find a day that that half you're allowed to do and half not? Because the eve of Passover we have this notion of unleavened bread and unleavened bread. Okay, mm-hmm. The prohibition of eating chametz, biblically speaking, applied to what? From chatzot, from the midst of the day. The sages add to that another boundary, which is hour two earlier. That's what we're going to say later. So he said, where is it? Amar lei, hu atzmo yochiyar, the 14th day himself will prove that applied part of the day, but not not the entire day. Why? Sharei miksato mutar be'achilat chametz, mutar asur be'achilat chametz. Because if you apply to the 14th, part of the day you can eat leavened bread, and part of the day you are forbidden to do it. So now we go deeper and we said, mi dekama Rabbi Yehuda mishata netzachama al ma'or dekama Rabbi Eliezer Yaakov u'tahu. So when you use the term from the dawn, apply to or night. The Gemara rejected, said, lo, my or amud ha-shachar. No, he meant to say when the sun rises. So yachid dekama le'echad matzim yom shem kusom u'tahu b'chsel mecham u'sbo asu b'chsel. So what does that mean when he said a day that part you're allowed to do a walk and part not? Neima iu le'nafshei, a person said to himself, v'ayika layla dekashare. Which means they have the eve that you can, you're allowed to do work. So Rabbi Eliezer ben Yaakov achikama, that's a response. If you go by my view, that the prohibition of doing work apply from the sunrise, ashkhanu dekapal gerabanan ben leyama lelela, which means that the sages divided between the eve and the day. The Tanya Gabet Tanit Zibur said in the Tractate Tanit, page 12, in regards to a public fasting day, that excluding the Day of Atonement, Yom Kippur and Tisha B'Av, always those fast days, depends how the rabbis made it, but many of them, they make, if it's not Yom Kippur and Tisha B'Av, make just from the sunrise, but there are certain situations that they go even the eve before. So, but here they said, one is a regular fasting day, take for example, Fast of Esther. Fast of Gedalia. Okay, so they ad she'aleh amud ha-shachar, divrei Rabbi Eliezer ben Yaakov, she'on omer ad krot ha-gaber. One said, when is the dawn? One said, from the sunrise, right? The krot ha-gaber is like the rooster start...
To crow,
thank you. Ela ledidach, heicha ashkechana yamar ha-gufe de palgi rabanan. Where do you find the sages that divided the day itself, that part allow, part not? Amar lei, Rabbi Yehuda respond, hu atzmo yochiach. 14 of Nisan who can prove שמקצתו מותר באכילת חמץ, ומקצתו אסור באכילת חמץ. A part of the day allowed to eat leavened bread, a part not. So the Gemara asked, Shapir ka amar le Rabbi Yehuda le Rabbi Eliezer. That's right what Rabbi Yehuda said to Rabbi Eliezer. What he respond? Har ka amar le Rabbi Eliezer, amin alach ana melacha de Rabbanan, va'at amart li chametz d'oraita. I'm telling you that doing work is rabbinic. And you tell me that chametz is biblical. Ad, de'ad achas achmana v'ad achas shar achmana. That up to this point, the Torah allowed, and the other point, not. So ve'idach, so how we respond to the that? So Rabbi Yehuda said, sha'ot de Rabbanan, which means this is a rabbinic to go by the hour that, biblically speaking, apply only from chatzot, from the middle of the day. The sages add about 2 hours of forbidden to eat chametz, so it means that the 4 hours of the early part of the day, you're allowed to eat chametz, and then, from that border of 2 hours, it's a rabbinic prohibition. So it means that rabbi themselves divided with the hours of the day. So even the Isur Melacha, the prohibition against doing work in the Erev Pesach, they divided between the sunrise, the dawn, and the middle of the day. So Rabbi Eliezer said, "Ve'idach harchakav d'avud rachman lo raita." That's what David always liked to say, that they put a boundaries, they put a border.
Fences, yep.
What? Fences, thank yep. you. So that's siag, that's the fences. Meitive. Ein masim masuot, ela al ha-chodesh shenira bizmano l'kadsho. In that time, the people come to the Bet Din and declare that it's they saw the moon and it's the time to do Rosh Chodesh. So the Bet Din send people with a torch to go to the top of the mountain. So when they do it, only from the 30 days of the previous month, ומתי מסיעים מסועות? Because they are month of 29, that it's a short one, and they are those months that they are 30 days in full. If you remember, it was a big discussion between Dr. Friedman and Rabbi Karp in regards to the full days or 29 days of the month. ומתי מסיעים מסועות? And so what's the time that they carry those torches at the top of the mountain? לאור עיבורו, על מאור אור טעו. So what we derive from that, that they're using or, again, is the opposite way, it's applied to the night. Shema mina, so again, of all these long discussion, apply that or is not literally meaning day, it's applied to, it's come to the searching of chametz, it's applied to the night before. Meitive, we challenge. Haya omed kol haylo makriv al ha-mizbeach. They said that the Kohen stand all night and bring the offering on the altar. So that's part of the Ola offering, that after they burn, they have the internal limb and part of the fat that the Torah said that they need to do it. So he do it when? La'ora ta'un kiddush yadayim v'raglayim. So, divrei rabbi. So it means that or applied to the day. So he said ora shani. So the word ora with hey is different than the or. So even Rav Yehuda that said that or apply to night, when he used the ora, apply to the day. So we first halacha, it's a Shulchan Aruch, Orach Chaim 431, Bdikat Chametz. One searches for leaven by candlelight at the beginning of the night of the 14th of the month of Nisan, just as the stars emerge, when a small amount of daylight remains. The Vilna Gaon said that one must search all holes, all those small places that he ordinarily take leavened bread. So we need to go to all those small places. My teacher and mentor, Reb Shlomo Zalman Auerbach, used to tell us that in a press circumstance, like hazard issue, you're allowed to go ahead and use a flashlight. But again, if you can, you should use candles in order to get to those spots that otherwise it's hard to get. We also talk about eating achila lifnei ta'anit, which means when is the time to eat before the fast. So on lenient fast days, like Tzom Gedalia, like Fast of Esther, like 17 of Tammuz that coming, one may eat at any point during the night until dawn. This is the opinion of Rabbi Yehuda Anasi, and the halacha is always used in according on his opinion in disputes with a single sage. The Gemara later in the tractate Ta'anit restricts this leniency to one who does not sleep at night, or one who stipulates before going to sleep that he will eat during the night. The Shulchan Aruch HaRachaim 564 there. Some rabbi said that if you did not stipulate in advance, you can't do that. The last halacha, we talk about La'ura Tun Kiddush Raglaim V'Raglaim. Here is the Rambam, Hilchot Beit HaMikdash, that will be rebuilt speedily soon in our days. So they said, a Kohen who engaged in the burning of sacrifice limp all night must wash his hands and feet again when it become light, as required to all priests before they begin to walk in the temple service, and it will be built speedily and soon in our days. Amen.